lines across my face tell you the story of who I am. So many stories of where I've been and how I got to where I am. But these stories don't mean anything when you got no one to tell them to. It's true, I was made for you. I've climbed across the mountain tops, swam all across the ocean blue. I've crossed all the lines and I broke all the rules, but baby, I broke them all for you. Because even when I was flat broke, well, you made me feel like a million bucks. You do. And I was made for you.
Seated. Before you exchange vows, I'd like to share some things that I've learned throughout my marriage and try to give a little advice. Despite what people will tell you, there's going to be some tough times. Times when you can't agree on something or just plain get mad at one another. You might think that those are the bad times, but those are actually the moments that will make your bond even stronger. Your love for each other will help you get through those tough patches. Just something simple like flowers for no reason, or bringing home your spouse's favorite food, even just their favorite snack, means a lot. And you have to learn how to make each other laugh, because that's the good stuff, it really is. Do we have rings?
Maybe.
I just asked before I came up.
Okay, we're gonna start with Julie. Place a ring on Holly's finger and repeat after me.
I, Julian Paxey. Take you, Holly Summerhill.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To take you as my lawfully wedded wife.
My constant friend. My faithful partner. And my love from this day forward. In the presence of our family and friends. I offer you my solemn vow. To be my faithful partner. In sickness and in health.
To enjoy in sorrow.
And in life as well as in death. I promise to love you unconditionally. To honor and respect you. To laugh with you.
To cry with you.
And to cherish you. Both in this life.
And in the next.
Okay, Holly. Place the ring on Julian's finger and repeat after me. I, Holly Summerhill. Take you, Julian Paxey.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
And my love from this day forward.
And my love from this day forward.
In the presence of our family and friends.
In the presence of our family and friends.
I offer you my solemn vow.
I offer you my solemn vow.
To be your faithful partner.
To be your faithful partner.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
And in life as well as in death.
And in life as well as in death.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To honor and respect you.
To honor and respect you.
To laugh with you.
To laugh with you.
And cry with you.
And cry with you.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
Both in this life.
Both in this life.
And in the next.
And in the next.
And with that, you may kiss the bride.
I loved working with her, though. No matter the storm she was going through, she always came in with a smile. And she very quickly became my best friend. And eventually my best roommate. Julian, you have the best roommate. And I'm honestly a little jealous of you right now. She would cook us roommates dinner. We would binge watch shows and scary movies and drink lots of wine straight out of the bottle because we didn't have a dishwasher, so less dishes. She also always did dishes, and she paid for rent early. The only bad thing was that she would leave me every weekend and go travel around for Color Guard, and I would just sit and wait for her to come back. Well, she would play this fun game where she would hide and wait for you to walk by and jump out and scare you and give you a heart attack. When I moved to Wisconsin, she would FaceTime me and we would talk for hours. I remember one day she was filling me in on her life since the last time we talked. She told me about the new guy in her classroom that she had started talking to. She was gushing and my heart melted. I knew she had found the one she was going to marry. The first time I met Julian was at a Lions versus Packers game in Detroit. This is my speech. My first thought was a nice beer. Him and Nate hit it off right away, of course, because they love football and coaching. Now I catch my lovely fiance messaging him about football and coaching as if they're BFFs. This is my dream, though. We're going to be BFFs, and our husbands are going to be BFFs. Our kids will always know their Aunt Heather and their Aunt Holly. You are my sister, Holly, and now I have a brother, and it's an amazing feeling. I am actually an only child, so it's going to be very hard, but I'm willing to share her. I love you so much, both of you. Welcome to the family, Julian.
For attending this amazing evening and celebration. Thanks to Heather for her speech. So everybody bust out your tissues for this speech. It's going to be a real tearjerker. So those who don't know me, I'm Max. I've known Julian for over 20 years now. What are you singing? That sounded like,
girls, girls,
girls. So I met Julian in sixth grade. Julian was rocking his Terry Labonte Kellogg's Mountain Dew Quaker State Chevrolet NASCAR jacket when I first met him. We have a bunch of great memories together, from Crew Fest in 2008 to the more recent Motley Crue Def Leppard concert that we went to on his bachelor party in Chicago, and hundreds of concerts in between. From high school parties to senior bar parties down in Albion. I know he has his Albion kids in here. Where they at? Where they at? Yeah, there they are. See? Go Brits, right?
Go Brits. Blue Scots.
Yeah, you're right. So we've shared a passion for sports and beater cars like the custom Dazed and Confused Celebrity and Geo Trackers. We've done so many things together. I could stand up here for hours and hours and hours and just go over story on story. And there's a lot of things that a lot of people here wouldn't understand, but there's a couple guys up here that we just laugh our asses off. I lost my spot now. But no matter how much I've tried to corrupt Julian, he has a heart full of love, passion, and drive, which led him to Holly. Holly's great, loving, caring individual who finally whipped Julian into shape. It takes an amazing person to so easily take on the role of a stepmom, and Holly had opened her arms to invite Kendall in as her own. We could not be more happy for you two and the life you two have created. So everyone raise your glasses, and we're going to toast to the new Mr. and Mrs. Julian.